Still my anxious rush toward rebellion. Let love keep my will upon its knee. Oh God, you are my God. Your commands are boundless and have none. Your word is my joy and meditation. From the rising to the setting of the sun, all your ways are loving and are faithful. The road is narrow, but your because you gladly lead to lead the humble, I shall gladly yield to leave my pride. Oh God, Jesus, turn your eyes upon me, for I know there is mercy in your sight. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We welcome you to worship on this 16th Sunday after Pentecost. I'm going to turn your attention briefly to the announcements found in your bulletin. Remind you that it has been a tradition here at St. Augustine that on the first Sunday of October, we celebrate and lift up the life and indeed the ministry of St. Francis of Assisi. This year will be no different. We'll have our annual Blessing of the Animals service, and it will be combined with our Eucharistic Evensong that's led by Bella Voce. So we encourage you to mark that on your calendar, and more importantly, to be sure to bring your feathered, your furried, and your finned friends to St. Augustine for the blessing. It's also a great evangelism opportunity, so we encourage you to invite family members and friends to this wonderfully festive service here in the nave, 5 o'clock, the 3rd of October. So remind you, at the end of the month, September the 26th at 4 o'clock, we will be participating in the OKC Pride on 39th Street. You remember there was a Pride Parade earlier in the summer, and so that one was rescheduled. So this is a different Pride Parade in which we will be joining other Episcopal churches in the region. So we encourage you to mark that on your calendar, 4 o'clock, the 26th of September. And if you want more information, be sure to be in touch with Lynn Nippers. Also, at the end of the month, Wednesday, the 29th of September at 11 o'clock in the morning, we begin a new adult Bible study. I'm entitling it All Night, All Day, Angels Watching Over Me. And we will look at the story, the history of angels from the beginning of in Genesis as they weave their way through the book of Revelation, and how angels were seen historically and how those unseen powers are indeed surrounding and protecting us. So if you want to know more about angels, be sure to be a part of that adult Bible study beginning 11 o'clock on Wednesday, September the 29th, which interestingly enough is the feast of St. Michael and all angels, and it will continue through the 3rd of November. While I was gone on my vacation, longest one that I've taken in 11 years, some 6 weeks, I was so pleased to know that the church was in good hands. That's because of you. That's also because of our staff and vestry and clergy. And so it's always a sense of comfort to know that things are being run well. In fact, sometimes they're run better while you're away. But our thanks to the Reverend Canon Tony Moon, Father Lance Schmidt, and our deployed deacon, Robbie Tremble, and all of you for your support in making sure that things were absolutely A-okay. So put your hands together for yourselves and for your brothers and sisters in Christ. Now, I think I remember how to do this. It's sort of like getting on a bike again, right? So we encourage you now to affirm the mission statement of this congregation as it's found in your bulletin on page 3 in English and Spanish. Together, we are an enthusiastically welcoming and inviting Christian community committed to the unity of all people with God through Christ. And as we say every time we gather in this sacred space, welcome, welcome to worship.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Now and forever.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, because without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated and invite the children to come forward for a brief children's moment.
Oh,
Perfect. Yeah. Great. Good morning. How are you today? Good. Great. What do you think I have in this box? You don't know. God only knows. Right. Well, let's find out. You want me to open it up? You want me to open it up?
Yes.
Let's see. We need a drum roll. Ta-da! What is it? Crosses. Look at all of those crosses. Yeah, it's like I'm a salesman and I want to sell what's in here. Have I got a great deal for you today? Well, there are all different types of crosses that have been given to me over the years. This one has stones, and this one right here is what's called a Celtic cross. And this one is a cross from Ethiopia, and this is a Greek cross, and this is a Jerusalem cross. And this cross is a model just like Pope Francis wears, and a former intern here gave that to me. Isn't that neat? Yeah, you remember that one. You like the red one? Yeah, see? Yeah. You like them? That's right. Aren't they neat? So it's like a bunch of treasure. Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, guess what? You can see crosses that people wear around their necks. Some people have crosses on a keychain. You can see crosses hung on walls. There's a big cross that's hung on the wall behind this. And guess what? Yeah, you've seen that one before. There's a cross on top of our bell steeple as well. And you know, you will hear the story of Jesus having a conversation with his disciples. And Jesus asked the question, well, who do people say that I am? And they say, well, some people say that you're like John the Baptist. And some people say you're like one of the good teachers or prophets. But who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you're the Messiah. And Jesus says, that's good, that's great, but don't tell that to anyone right now. And Peter pulled Jesus aside and said, I really don't understand. And Jesus told those disciples and told Peter, you know what? I don't want you to tell anyone right now because I'm going to have to suffer and I'm going to have to die on the cross, but I'll be raised on the third day. And Peter said, you got it all wrong, Jesus. That's messed up. And Jesus told Peter, you know what? You really don't have the right mindset. You're putting your mind on earthly things, not divine things. And then Jesus had a conversation with the crowd that was gathered. And he said, you know what? If you want to be a follower of mine, you need to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. You know what it means to follow Jesus? Jesus gave his life for you and for me out of love for the whole world. And to be a follower of Jesus means that you have to love people, love everyone, and try to model your life after Jesus. So, you know, we can wear crosses around our necks, and that's wonderful because that reminds us of the one who loved us the most. And you're right, the cross is the best treasure ever. So I invite you to prepare to follow the cross to Children's Chapel. And as we do that, I invite all of you to say the prayer together that's found in the bulletin as we send the youngest of our disciples forth to hear stories about Jesus. Together, oh loving God, we release our children to a time of Children's Chapel as they explore their faith through sharing of Bible stories. Be with them in the sacred time of wonder and prayer. May they sense both your constant presence and your love. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. I invite you to go to Children's Chapel. Thanks, friends. Follow the cross. help you down? Okay. Step. Boom. There you go.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with the word. Morning by morning, he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord has opened my ear and was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult or spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint. And I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And on the way he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" They answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." He asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter answered him, "You are the Messiah." And he sternly ordered them not to tell anyone about him. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, but turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." And he called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them if they gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation of Peter and the other disciples, they know the truth, right? Jesus is God's anointed one. But Jesus doesn't want them to tell anyone this until they understand what it means to follow the kind of Messiah Jesus is. And if they don't know what it means for their lives as well, Jesus doesn't want them proclaiming him as the Messiah and implying that they are faithful followers. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We don't understand what it means, Jesus? No, you don't have the entire picture yet. It's not until after Jesus' betrayal, his crucifixion and death and resurrection, that they understand fully what he meant by he said that he was the Messiah, the Mashiach, the anointed one of God. Do as I say, not as I do. Far too often, the church has loudly proclaimed Jesus as the Christ while living in opposition to that very title. What if the church had actually heeded this command more frequently over 2 millennia? The church that began as a movement for the underside of society. Jesus' proclamation of love for all, inclusivity for all peoples and genders, love of enemy, nonviolence, peacemaking, drew all sorts of people who didn't have power in the society. Didn't have social status, so to speak. And Jesus' gospel was a liberating word of good news, not for some, not for a few, but for all. Those who were poor, as well as those who were wealthy. Those who were outcast, as well as the insider. When the church became the dominant political force in the Roman Empire, the life of Christ, that path of self-giving love, the way of God, that Jesus came to teach and invite all of us to follow, it went by the wayside. And I remember the words a quarter of a century ago of my father, who said, you know, when the church began to lose her true identity, he said, Jojo, it's when the church became legal under Constantine. Whoa, Dad, you don't know what you're talking about. Daddy, you knew what you were talking about. Yeah. Christians went from people who wouldn't participate in war to an established church using armies to advance its power. The cross, the sign of divine sacrificial love, became a military talisman painted on shields. And so the church did the Crusades. Any of you ever read about the Crusades? The Inquisition and countless heresy trials and executions and wars and massacres in the name of Christ became more powerful than emperors and more armies and castles and wealth than kings could have ever dreamt of. Don't tell anyone I'm the Messiah, Jesus sternly ordered his disciples, because this is what flourished into a church responsible for more death and destruction than almost any other institution. Wow. Is that what you learned over your vacation, Father Joe? You come back to preach that kind of message? Who do you say I am? Is more than an informational question. Jesus says that your answer to his question determines your path. If you say he is the anointed one of God, the Mashiach, the Messiah, you admit that God's Christ went to Jerusalem, was arrested, and brutally executed on a cross. You claim that path for yourself? That's scary. Don't say who I am, Jesus says today. Rather, do who I am. Live who I am. The truth be told, my brothers and sisters, that's a frightening thing. To do who Jesus is, to live as Jesus lived. If you say that Jesus is God's Messiah, you only have one option for following: to live and to love as he lives and loves. Following Jesus is denying yourself. Following Jesus is losing your life. Following Jesus is taking up a cross. Jesus is dying on the cross. Isn't amazing love. That's amazing grace. Oh, the wondrous cross. So you say, that's fine and dandy, Father. Pick up the cross. Try to be like Jesus. Indeed, my friends, that's what we're called to do. To be the body of Christ in the world, so that we might right the wrongness in our world. And by mere fact that we have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection, we are commissioned to be that body of Christ in the world. We are called to be the hands and the feet and the eyes and the heart of Christ. Apostle Paul reminds us in that first letter to the church in Corinth, the eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you, nor can the head say to the feet, I have no need of you, because we're all a part of the body of Christ. We need everyone to indeed live into their God-given potential. Head and shoulders, knees and toes. What part of the body are you? Say, well, maybe I'm struggling to understand what part of the body I am. That's okay. Those who struggle with their faith are invited and welcome to this place. But be assured that because you have been baptized into Christ, Christ has endowed you with a gift to help and make the world a better place. And when your gift is joined with my gift, then we can truly live into the body that God intended and make a difference, not only in our community, but indeed it will have ripple effects around the world. That wonderful Spanish mystic and reformer, theologian, and poet, Teresa of Avila, put it this way: Christ has no body but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks with compassion on this world. Yours are the feet with which he walks to do good. Yours are the hands through which he blesses the world. Do as I say, not as I do, just doesn't work for Christ's people. Jesus would tell you that it will be better not to claim who he is at all if you don't want to follow his path. But I know that's not the case here this morning. Because if you have come to know the undying love of God seen through Jesus' words and grace and sacrifice, if you found hope in his teaching and wisdom in his dying and the joy in his living, then take a leap like Peter and say, yes, yes, you are the Messiah. Yes, I'm willing to follow you wherever you lead. And maybe it begins with following him today. And here's how you can dare to follow Jesus today and model your life after his and make a difference in the world. In your bulletin, you will find a light green insert. And originally, we planned this to be Ministry Sunday, and guess what? It still is. Because on this sheet, you will find 30-plus ministries that seek to be the eyes and the hands and the feet and, dare I say, the beating heart of Christ. And you can be a part of the body. You have a part to play. Maybe you can't sing like angels, but you're great with holy hospitality. Maybe you say, I have no fear of standing in front of people and I'm willing to read a passage of scripture. Or maybe you're willing to help the youngest among us, the next generation, teach them those biblical stories. There is a place for you. Maybe you're willing to be an usher. Simply look at the boxes. My brothers and sisters, I implore you to check off one or two ministries. Maybe you say, I really don't understand what those ministries are all about. Then I encourage you to look at the back of your bulletin, and there is a short explanation about each one of those ministries. Check the box as the Spirit leads you. And then flip that sheet on the other side and be sure to put your name on there so that we don't have to play guess who it was who filled out that particular ministry. Amen? And here's the challenge. You know, I love to challenge you, right? At our 8:30 service, and Reverend Canon Tony Moon is here to testify. Let's see if I'm telling the truth. We had over 22 people, I believe. Almost 25 people in that service who filled out a sheet and put it in the baptismal font. I'm going to invite you as Scott leads us in a time of meditation to fill out one of those ministries and then to place that sheet in the baptismal font, because it's from the font that we are all commissioned, that we're all made a part of the body of Christ. It's through the font that we are called and commissioned and sent out to be the hands and the feet and the eyes and the heart of Christ in the world.
Can you hear me? Is that better? Okay. So a few things. First of all, if anyone would prefer to use technology, if you're not familiar with the QR code, you can open your camera on your phone and you just scan the QR code and it immediately takes you to our Sign Up Genius site. Or if you have a QR reader, it accomplishes the same goal. And then additionally, I wanted to point out to you, someone asked me after the early service, on the signups under the community outreach ministries on the left at the bottom is Here I Am, Send Me. This is a new ministry that we developed last year, which is basically an opportunity to volunteer in multiple different areas. If a certain need comes up, a certain project comes up, maybe we need someone to take a donation somewhere, maybe there's a project here at the church, it could be any number of things. You're willing to say, hey, I'll consider that, and if the timing works out, if the opportunity works out, great. If not, that's okay too. But if you're curious about the Here I Am, Send Me, go ahead and check that off. And I'll also be available after the service if anyone would like to talk more and learn more about any of these. Anything else, Father Joseph? Great. Thank you all.
myself, and I will be ever only all for thee, all for thee.
Now that God has spoken to us, let us speak to God, recalling our beliefs. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace we pray to you, O Lord, for all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble. For the peace and unity of the Church of God, especially for the ministries of those churches in the diocesan cycle of prayer, St. Andrew's Grove, Center for the Assistance of Infants and Families, Ministry for Education and Welfare of Young Children, and the Diocese of Uruguay.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek truth.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Paulson, our bishop, and for all bishops, Father Joseph, Father Tony, Father Lance, Deacon Robbie, Deacon Karen, and all other ministers.
For all
we pray for those with medical issues and other concerns. For those in the military. And we pray for our troops at home and abroad and their families. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy, we pray.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. We rejoice with those celebrating birthdays this week, Mary Dale Vanek, Joshua Harlow, Evelyn Thrower, Mark Dillard, Charles Pollard, Marcy Frensley, Robbie Trammell, Jeannie Haas, and Frank Stone. And we rejoice with those celebrating anniversaries this week, Tom and Diane Norton, and Mark and Marcia Tigert. We will exalt you, O God, our King. We pray for all those who have died, that they might have a peace in your eternal kingdom. We remember Alma Brown and Craig Hill. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them
who put their trust in you. Let us most humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Please stand. And the peace of the Lord be always with you. Share a sign of peace. Do you have anything? Oh, okay. All right. Before I turn him loose, let's welcome Father Joseph back. Hey.
I said at the first service how pleased I was to see the number of people place those time and talent sheets, those ministry sheets in the font. And I turned over to Canon Moon and I said, you know, be sure to give my love to your beloved, how she puts up with my crazy ideas. Because one never knows how it's going to turn out. A preacher doesn't know if the congregation will respond. And again, at this service, to see your response to the move of the Spirit. Thanks be to God, but also thanks be to our senior warden for saying yes to the crazy idea. And thanks be to Sarah Emily, okay? All of us together in staff making this come together. Thank you. It gives me hope and the assurance that the church will remain vital and continue to do God's work in God's world. Amen? So put your hands together, a sign of praise to God for what will be done. Merci.
Now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
There's a singer there.
continuing on page 9. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being, sun, moon, and stars, earth, winds, and waters, and every living thing. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we say, praise to you, holy and living God, to deliver us from the power of sin and death and to reveal the riches of your grace. You looked with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, and broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Now gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ, crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer to you our gifts of bread and wine, and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with all your saints from every tribe and language and people and nations to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor and glory, praise forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Hallelujah.
The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Communion today will be continuous, receiving bread at the head of this main aisle. Please take a napkin from the usher to receive both bread and wine. After you use this napkin, then please place it in one of these receptacles, these wicker baskets up here, so that they may be properly disposed of. By not taking a napkin, you signal to us that you will receive bread only, or by crossing your arms over your chest, you'll let us know that you wish to only receive a blessing. Gluten-free is available upon request. After you receive communion, if you wish, you may go to one of the two candle stands, light a candle, say a prayer, and then return to your seats by the side aisle. You're at the direction of the ushers. Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life.
On a hill,
may God's blessing be with you.
Far away,
amen.
Stood an old rugged cross. The emblem of suffering and shame, and I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain.
Oh,
including on page 12, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a reminder that Father Lance will be in the chapel after this service is concluded for prayers for birthdays, anniversaries, or any other prayer requests that you may have. Please receive the blessing. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.